Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll study about the cell division. The cell division is the most dramatic period of the cell cycle. The cell division includes the mitosis. Here, mito in the sense thread and sis in the sense state. Mitosis is nothing but a thread state. Walther Fleming was the first person to show the mitosis in an animal cell during the year 1879. The mitosis is also known as the equational division, since the number of chromosomes in the parent and the progeny cell is the same. Hence, it is known as the equational division. The mitosis takes place in the somatic cells, that is the body cells. It also takes place in the germinal cells during the multiplicative phase. The mitosis is also having the several phases in it. Those are prophase, metaphase, anaphase and the telophase. Coming to the prophase, it is the first stage of mitosis. Here the chromosomes become short and thick due to condensation. Hence, the chromosome condenses. See the first diagram. This is the early prophase. Here, the chromosomes are thin thread-like. Hence, these chromosomes are known as chromatin. Okay, these chromatin starts to condenses to become a thick and short. Each chromosome is formed of two chromatids, and the two chromatids of the chromosomes are connected by a centromere. After the condensation, there will be a formation of two chromatids which are held together by a centromere. Okay. And the centriole, which have been already duplicated or already divided during the S phase of the cell cycle, they start to move to the opposite poles. The centrioles, which have been already duplicated, they start to move to the opposite poles. Okay, there is a formation of thin delicate fibers which around the each pair of the centrioles. These fibers appear like a stars, hence these are known as the esters. Along with the esters, there are long, thin, delicate fibers. These are known as spindle fibers. The spindle fibers along with the esters are known as the spindle apparatus. The esters along with the spindle fibers is known as the spindle apparatus. The nuclear membrane and the nucleolus start to disappear in the prophase. Okay. During prophase, the chromosome condenses and the two chromatids are held together by the centromere. The centrioles start moving to the opposite poles. There will be a delicate fibers which appears like a star. Those are known as esters. And there is a formation of delicate fibers from one pole to the another pole of the esters. Those are known as the spindle fibers. The spindle fibers along with the esters are known as the spindle apparatus. The nuclear membrane and the nucleolus start to disappear. Next phase is the metaphase. This metaphase is identified by the fully formed the spindle apparatus, and the chromosomes are present at the equatorial region. The chromosomes which have been become short and thick with a distinct chromatids move towards the equatorial plane and get attached to the spindle fibers of the to the centromere, and the arms of the chromosomes are swinging. Okay, the spindle fibers which are attached to the centromere are known as the chromosomal spindle fiber or the discontinuous spindle fiber. And the fibers which are extending from one pole to the another pole, these chromosomes are known as the continuous chromosomes. Okay. In metaphase, the chromosomes are present at the equatorial regions. These spindle fibers are attached to the centromere. This spindle fibers which are attached to the centromere, these spindle fibers are known as the discontinuous spindle fibers or the chromosomal spindle fibers. And the spindle fibers which are extending from one pole to the another pole, those spindle fibers are known as the continuous spindle fibers or the continuous spindle fibers. Next phase is the anaphase. Anaphase begins with the division of the centromere, okay, and the separation of the sister chromatids. Here during metaphase, in anaphase the centromeres divides and there is a separation of the sister chromatids. The chromosomes start moving to the opposite poles. Here the chromosomes start moving to the opposite poles. The movement of chromosome is brought about by the constriction of the chromosomal fibers, okay, or the spindle fibers. These are fibers which occurs between the sister chromatids are known as the interzonal fibers. Okay, the fibers which are present between the chromosomes, those fibers are known as the interzonal fibers. During anaphase, the centromere divides and the sister chromatids separates and move towards the opposite pole. In the telophase, the furrow occurs or the constriction occurs in the cell and the chromosomes become decondenses to form the chromatin fibers. The nucleolus and the nuclear envelope reappears. The spindle fibers get break down and absorbed in the cytoplasm. Hence, there will be a two daughter nuclei formed at the opposite poles. Next one is cytokinesis. In a cytokinesis, this furrow deepens. This furrow deepens and there will be a formation of two daughter cells. And there will be a formation of two daughter cells forming a two daughter cells which are having the chromosomes as the same number of chromosomes present as that of the parent cell. Mitosis is thus completed with the two daughter cells. Now, significance of mitosis. What is the use of this mitosis? It maintains the equal distribution of chromosomes between the two daughter cells. This mitosis helps to maintain the equal number of chromosomes between the two daughter cells. This mitosis helps in the growth of multicellular animals, plants brought about by the mitosis. Okay, which is brought about by the mitosis. Okay, next, this mitosis helps in healing the wound, replacement of the dead cells and regeneration takes place with the help of this mitosis. These are the significance of mitosis. Okay, thank you.